And now, here is your host, linguist, published author, teacher, and world traveler, Bud Brown.
Howdy, Bud Brown here, living in the Philippines. Yeah, baby. I love it here. I love living in the Philippines. It's different, that's for sure. But anyway, what I wanted to do in this video is just kind of give you an update on my wallet that I lost. If you've been following my videos, you know, I didn't want to say it out loud, but I'm trying to do a video every day. But I'm afraid if I make an official announcement that I'm going to do that, then I just, my rebellious nature would just say, I'm not going to make one today. So, unofficially, I'm going to try to make one every day, but if it comes to every 2 days or 3 days, then that's the way it is. And that's a good segue onto one of the things that I wanted to bring out is that my life here, I'm retired. I have a small pension. And as I'm getting older, I'm realizing, you know, I want to stay away from stress. I want to make my life beneficial to others if possible. But if there's people that I cannot help or there's things that I cannot do, I'm not going to feel guilty. I'm not. If you've been following my videos, you know that I've kind of gotten into the habit of giving away these flip-flops. I mean, they're cheap, and a lot have been donated to me. I appreciate that so much. And along with Band-Aids and first aid equipment. So, you know, in my daily life, I run across these situations where I can help others, and that's really a good feeling. But getting back to the wallet, if you saw that one video, and someone pointed it out to me because I didn't see it, we stopped at this banana stand where Gloria picks up a bunch of bananas, and I'm talking to this young boy. I guess he was said he was in second grade. And just chit-chat, what's your name, how old are you, what grade are you in, this and that. And then someone pointed out that he had reached down to the ground, got up, turned around, it looked like he had something under his shirt as he walked away. Well, lo and behold, as we were getting ready to take off, I couldn't find my wallet. So we looked around, we shot back right away to the restaurant that I went to, and I retraced my tracks was what happened. Couldn't find it. I was expecting to see it along the road or something. Well, I told myself I'm going to take some photos from that video and kind of spread it around the neighborhood so if anybody knows this boy. So we went back to the banana shack. The lady there says, that's my grandson. Well, her son came there, and he looked like he was starting to get upset. And he said, I'm going to talk with him as soon as he gets home from school. Well, I told him, I said, I have a video that, I mean, it doesn't show him with the wallet per se, but it just looks like he may have found it. So a couple hours later, they came by the house and wanted to see the video. So I showed him the video, and I heard the wife say, nah, nah, which means he has, it looks like he has it. So they said, we're gonna bring him back after school to take a look at this video. So a couple hours later, they came, and the boy was there, kind of sheepishly looking. You know, he looked kind of like he'd been real guilty, but what do I know? So they said, show him the video. So I showed it to him. And then the man in English says, what was the word? You interview him. You know, interview is a word that normally you use for when you're applying for a job. But I know the idea. He was saying, ask him questions. You interview him. So this was very awkward to me. The little boy was sitting here on the couch. The mom was sitting in one chair. The dad was sitting in another chair. And I said, does he speak English? No. Does he speak Tagalog? No. So I do speak Bisaya, but very, very little bit, and not enough to make it a comfortable situation. So I just spoke in Tagalog, and the mom interpreted it so the boy could understand. But basically, did you pick up a wallet, or did you see a wallet there? And the boy says, uh-uh. He didn't say, he just kind of shook his head. And then, well, what was it in the video? It looked like you picked up something and put it on your shirt. He says, bato. Bato means a rock or a stone. So, well, what did you do with it? I threw it over the fence. So, you know, here's the thing where my philosophy and my attitude may be different from others. I felt guilty for having bringing this up. I felt like saying, I'm so sorry that he may have stolen this wallet from me, you know, which sounds ridiculous, but I did. I'm thinking, man, I know kids need to be held accountable. I know that. But I felt very awkward. And the mom and dad, I don't think, believed him, but hey, he's sticking with his story. And of course, he's starting to cry that it was a rock. He just picked up a rock, that's all it was. So inside, I told myself, I'm not going to win the battle and lose the war. Oh, I could have badgered him, and I mean, I'm a teacher, I'm a professional at getting kids to to come out with the truth. But it was so awkward that I just wanted to let it go. It was maybe $10 worth of cash in the wallet, plus my Filipino driver's license, which is the worst thing that I wanted to lose. But there's times here when you have to say, what's worth what? Yeah, but it's the principle of the thing. I know, I hear you. But I'm not going to, what I call, hold on to the golden anchor. I mean, the anchor is bringing me down to the sea bottom, but it's worth something. It's gold, it's valuable, but, you know, I'm just going to let it go. So, whether I did the right thing or the wrong thing, my guiding principle is to stay away from stressful situations, if possible. I understand life is full of stressful situations, but if possible, I try to stay away from stressful situations. And I felt that I would just say, okay, it was probably a stone, wink, wink, nudge, nudge, and just let it go. And so, I mean, we go by the banana shack, and it's kind of a little bit awkward situation, but you know, I'm just, for my own health, mental health, I'm just gonna let it go. And I'll go down and get me another Philippine driver's license, and that's that. So I know some will say, yeah, but you should have done this, you should have done that. I know. Just like the boy that scratched my seat in the Molly Mobile. You know, I could have steamed and stewed and got riled up about it, but I'm not gonna do it. Same with my wallet. You know, there was no credit cards in it, thank goodness. There was nothing really that couldn't be replaced, so I'm letting it go. And I learned my lesson, put my wallet in my front pocket, or just be more careful with it. So that's what the deal is with the wallet. You know, I'm letting it go, I'm not gonna pursue it, and so that's the way I maintain my mental health here in the Philippines. there's a lot that you can get upset about. But I'm not going to do it because I'm retired. I got a good life here, and that's the way I maintain my attitude. Just let it go and move on. Talk to you later. Bye-bye.